Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. If you're a traveler, which if you click this video in the first place, you most likely are, and are wondering whether it is better to book your accommodation with booking.com or Airbnb, then this video is made for you. In it, I will be comparing the most relevant aspects between both of these platforms, and after comparing them all, I will be giving my personal opinion on which one is the best as a traveler. With that said, and before we go into the topic of the video, I just want to briefly mention that a few weeks ago I published already a comparison between Airbnb and booking.com, but from a host perspective. So if you are planning on listing your property in either one of these two platforms, of course I highly recommend that you watch that video. But even if you're not planning on doing so, I think that it's also interesting to watch it to understand better the functioning of both of these platforms. Anyways, I will leave the video here above for you in case you're interested, and also down below in the description. Now yes, let's go into the comparison. And I will start with the price point, because I feel like this is one of the most important determinants whenever booking accommodation, or as a matter of fact, anything in life. And on that, I must say that it's very hard for me to lean towards any of these two platforms, because the truth is that they are very similar. And in fact, professional hosts that I understand personally, professional hosts as hotels or, for instance, vacation rental management companies that manage several units or properties, they usually rent or lease the exact same property in both of these platforms, in Airbnb and booking.com. So you could see the exact same house listed on both, and probably also with the same price. And I'm also talking from personal experience, because I used to work for almost 2 years for a vacation rental management company in Barcelona. However, it is true that Airbnb is used more often by non-professional hosts, so essentially people like maybe you watching or me that might have a spare room in our apartment or just an additional property, and then we decide to rent it through Airbnb. While booking.com has typically been linked to more professional hosts and especially hotels. And what it's important to understand is that while with non-professional hosts, usually they don't apply very good revenue management practices, this is certainly not the case with professional hosts, so hotels, because they really try to maximize the revenue that they are getting from their listing. Can this lead to individual hosts pricing their listings at lower prices? Yes, it can be the case, but it could also be the opposite, that maybe they have just a flat rate throughout the year, but they don't care and they always keep the same regardless of whether it's high or low season. And then maybe they don't rent it for as many days as they could, and therefore they are not maximizing the revenue that they are making, which this is certainly not the case with companies. The thing though is that the difference between Airbnb and booking.com has been shrinking over the years. While Airbnb, as we commented, initially started also with regular people, maybe regular households like you and me, renting our properties, now more and more hotels and professional hosts have started entering Airbnb and also listing their properties there. And on the other hand, booking.com, that started traditionally just with hotels or basically professional hosts, now also allows for individuals like you and me to rent our properties there. Now that I have exposed some key aspects, let's go into other important ones to understand better the pricing, which are the commissions. On that, I really made a very detailed explanation on the other video I mentioned comparing Airbnb and booking.com, which is down below in the description. But essentially we have that booking.com charges all the commission to the host and no commission at all to the guest. While on the other hand, Airbnb charges most of the commission to the guest, which ranges between a 7 and a 14.2% and only a 3% commission to the host. Just looking at this, and since we're looking at it from a traveler's perspective, we could easily think or assume that it is much better to book with booking.com because the guest does not pay any commission and everything goes to the host. But you need to understand that regardless of who pays the commission, the host or the guest, it always ends up being reflected on the final price. And at the end of the day, both of these two platforms end up getting between a 15 and a 17% of the total price that you pay of the listing in commissions. Maybe I would say that booking.com gets a little bit more on average than Airbnb, but the difference is not massive. So unless a company does extremely bad revenue management practices, imagining that they list the exact same property on both booking.com and Airbnb, you should expect to pay the exact same to book that property regardless of the platform that you use to book it. Next on the list is the number of listings and the assortment of accommodation establishments that each one of these two platforms offers. And on that, Airbnb, as of September 30th, 2020, had around 5.6 million active listings globally, which might seem already quite a while ago. But then if you go to the latest earnings report for Q1 of 2021, it says that overall, the number of active listings and experiences was consistent with Q4 of 2020. And then if we go to the press release of Q4 of 2020, we see that it literally says that active listings and experiences were relatively stable during Q4 compared with Q3 of 2020. So basically, we can assume that the number of listings still to date is of 5.6 million. On the other hand, Booking.com states in their website that they offer more than 28 million total reported accommodation listings, including more than 6.2 million listings alone of homes, apartments, and other unique places to stay. It does not really say active listings, but imagining that all of these that we mentioned of 28 million are active listings, we could be looking at Booking.com having 5 times more listings than Airbnb. So in terms of choice, you do have more choice with Booking.com. But we also need to consider that Booking.com was founded in 1996 and Airbnb only in 2008. Which means that Booking.com has 12 years of advantage versus Airbnb, which essentially is almost double the time of what Airbnb has existed for so far. And also, in terms of Booking.com, they are already very well established and extended all over the world, while with Airbnb, it is mostly present in the United States or in North America, let's say, and also Europe, which are its more strong regions. Of course, they are also in other parts of the world, but at a much lower scale. And in fact, if we look at the countries in which Airbnb has more listings, first it is the US, which is obvious, and it is its home market. And then the next 4 countries are in Europe. Now let's talk about convenience. And this will be very personal, but I will expose all of the different points on how each platform works, and then you can decide for yourself. But for me, the winner here is Airbnb. And why is that? Well, it all has to do with how the transaction takes place versus if you compare it with Booking.com. In Airbnb, when you make a reservation, you pay everything upfront, and afterwards you just have to exchange a few messages with the host to coordinate your arrival and done. With Booking.com, there are 3 different options. It could be that it's the same case as Airbnb, you pay everything upfront and then that's it. The second option is that you sometimes have to pay something like 30% in advance and then the rest you pay it at the establishment. And in some other cases, you pay everything directly at the establishment and you can make the reservation without having to put any money down. If it is any other than the first option, then this is bad in my opinion. Because once you get to the establishment, you still need to do some more paperwork. And it's not just about that, but if you are paying with your card in a different country with a different currency, you also risk paying higher conversion rates from your currency. And then the worst argument for me is regarding the deposit, because with Booking.com, most establishments charge a deposit. And with it is essentially maybe they will just block 200 euros from your card. But imagine that you leave the establishment and then the property owner thinks that you damaged something and then directly they can easily take it from that deposit that you left. And then you essentially have no way of claiming this back or it is very, very hard. Instead, in the case of Booking.com, they offer a guarantee of $1 million to all the hosts for in case guests do damages to their properties, which means that in Airbnb, hosts don't charge any deposits. So if you're traveling with Airbnb, you pay your thing and no more deposits on that. And even if there are issues then during the stay and there's something that they claim, there's always Airbnb in between, mediating between the host and the guest. So it is always harder that they end up getting more money from you with Airbnb as a traveler. Turning things around though, there is actually something good about Booking.com, which is that if you only have to pay the full amount of the booking once you actually make use of the establishment, this means that you have more money available in the present that you can use maybe to invest it and generate more money before you have to pay that expense, which is always preferable. Instead, in the case of Airbnb, whenever you make the reservation, in that moment, you already need to pay everything upfront. Usually, to be honest, it doesn't make much of a difference with individual hosts. Maybe with companies, yes, but I doubt it because the accommodation expenses that they might have for, I don't know, business trips are relatively small in comparison to all the expenses that a company has. But as I said, I consider this to be an advantage for Booking.com. Touching now on something that I briefly mentioned before, we have the part of communication and interaction with the host. On this, it is again hard to lean towards any of the two, but in Airbnb, generally speaking, you can expect to have or to have to exchange a few more messages to coordinate your arrival when comparing it with booking.com, and especially if you are talking about hotels or other blocks of apartments maybe that have a receptionist. But as we said previously, now with booking.com there are also individual hosts, and now also in Airbnb you can also find hotel rooms and also professional hosts that maybe have already a receptionist. So again, this is a bit of a stereotype. And finally, also with Airbnb, and generalizing once more, you can also expect to have more interaction with the host than with booking.com, that generally speaking, it is more used for business purposes. Finally, the last topic that I want to touch on is the customer service of both of these platforms. And this is important to know it, especially if then something goes wrong. And on that, I must say that I have very positive experiences both with Airbnb and booking.com, so I cannot say anything bad about either one of them. But if you go online, check different forums and reviews, you will see bad reviews for both Airbnb and booking.com. And the truth is that being the middleman is always hard. It's hard to keep both parties happy. And the hardest part is that Airbnb or booking.com, yes, you book the accommodation through them, but they are not the final providers and they have no real control over how your experience is. So your satisfaction is more determined by the final host, the final provider of the accommodation, than by the platform that you use to book it. With this last point, it is time now for my final thoughts. And let's just say that if I had to choose between two exact same properties with the exact same price, one listed in Airbnb and the other one in booking.com, I would book it with Airbnb. However, the only reason for that is the convenience of the payments, and especially, as I mentioned earlier on, that you don't have to pay a deposit, which is something that I don't like. And also, finally, I have much more affinity towards the brand of Airbnb that already from the very beginning started with the revolution of peer-to-peer accommodation, which has enabled a lot of households, a lot of regular people that maybe had additional units to generate some extra income, and sometimes not even just to generate some extra income, but to build a business around it. Overall though, I think that both platforms are great, and just how satisfied you end up being when booking an accommodation with either one of these will only, as I already mentioned before, or mostly depend just on the final host, the final provider, and not so much on whether you choose to book it through Airbnb or booking.com. With that said though, this is the end of the video, but now I would like to know your thoughts. Which one do you prefer, Airbnb or booking.com? Also, I think that it would be great if you could drop in the comments below if you have had any bad experiences. Also, of course, if you have had good ones, because maybe it can help add some more value and help us decide which one of the two is better when we are traveling. With that said though, as I said, this is the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, then I would very much appreciate it if you could give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you are not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.